Well, the fight over a city vegetable garden is far from over. Jason and Jennifer Halvinston are at the center of the controversy because of a large garden they have in their front yard. City officials have ticketed them for violations. Now the couple may have scored their first victory. WESH 2 Stuart Moore was at their hearing today and has the results.
Dismissed the action against the
family. At a municipal planning board meeting, the city attorney announced a ticket for violating a city ordinance by growing this huge garden in College Park was being dismissed. Jason and Jennifer Halvinston started growing the garden when Jason was laid off from his job. Current city ordinances are too vague, City Attorney Kyle Shepherd says, and it's not against the rules for them to have it. But a new plan presented to the municipal board Tuesday morning puts restrictions that Halvinston say would eliminate most of their growing area.
Bottom line, this isn't about aesthetics. This is about somebody wanting to shove what they want down our throats.
The city proposal would limit the size of the garden you could have in your front yard and require some type of planter boxes or screens around plants. The city says this is just an initial proposal, and they are looking for ways to find an equal balance.
The purpose behind the public hearing and what the planning board is doing today, and ultimately city council will do, is try to weigh the interest of all the different viewpoints out there and try to come to some happy middle ground.
The Halvinstons have gotten support around the globe and locally collected 10,000 signatures to continue growing their garden. The city is looking to August 1st, the beginning of the fall planting season, to implement the new regulations. This municipal board will simply pass on a recommendation to council before anything new is passed.
Is there an equal medium that you think can be reached?
I really don't know, but until we start communicating, that's not going to have a chance. And right now, it's just been a tit for tat between us and the city.
What both sides understand is that this is just the beginning of the discussions to come up with some type of proposal that could possibly try to make both sides happy, but we are expecting at least months to go before that final proposal is written. In Orlando, Stuart Moore, WESH 2 News.